sister, I assume?
Until I get home and kill her. That's Sarah, the youngest. What's up? You didn't come by to eavesdrop on family mail.
Your family seems to be important to you.
Yeah, we've always been close. Me and my sisters especially. With Dad on duty so much, I had to help Mom raise them.
After helping raise them, your sisters still talk to you? Amazing.
Things were tense between Sarah and me for a while. Then we bonded.
Sounds like a story. Feel like sharing?
Sarah got herself a boyfriend who wanted to go faster than she did. Mike. I didn't think he was a bad kid, just pushy. Lynn would send me these worried vid mails, and I'd tell her to relax.
Sounds like that situation didn't last.
Mike thought they'd go for a romantic walk in the woods, because he figured it was past time they did the deed. She levered Mike face first into a tree and left. Didn't have a scratch on her. Good thing Mom and Dad had us all learn some kind of self-defense. I took emergency leave and walked Sarah to school for a few days.
Did anything happen while you were home?
My last day out, Mike was waiting for us. Sarah had told her friends, so everyone at school knew what he did. He wasn't happy. I wanted to snap him in half, but Sarah gave me this look. This, let me handle it, I need to do this alone look. She kept her cool, God bless her, as he screamed in her face. She just let him vent. Then he tried to punch her. I swear, she just flowed around him. Next thing I knew, he's face down on the sidewalk, and there's blood everywhere.
That's unbelievable. Sarah must be as good as you.
Better. I'm more or less a straight-up puncher. When he swung, she wasn't there anymore, and he fell. She helped him stop the bleeding and had me call an ambulance. She told the paramedics he fell. Before they took him to the hospital, Mike touched Sarah's arm. I thought he was going to end up on the ground again. But he hung his head, whispered, "I'm sorry," and started crying. And she hugged him. The Williams women are a decisive bunch, Commander. We do things when we're ready. Not before, not after.
Where was your father during this? Wasn't your family stationed near him?
Dad always wanted to serve in space, but he wanted us to have real ground under our feet. He'd say, space is beautiful, but you can't raise a family there. I cannot rest from travel. I will drink life to the lees. All times I've enjoyed greatly have suffered greatly, both with those that loved me and alone. For always roaming with a hungry heart, much have I seen and known. Cities of men and manners, climates, councils, governments.
I didn't know you liked classical literature.
Ulysses was my dad's favorite poem. Every time he shipped out, he recorded me reading it. He had a dozen versions when he retired.
Does he still like it?
I sure hope so. I read it to his grave every time I go home. Dad passed on a few years back. He's probably still watching, though.
I thought you said he was dead.
You know, from heaven, wherever that is. That's not a problem with you, is it? That I believe in God?
Your beliefs are your business. I'm your commanding officer, not your moral compass.
I appreciate that, Skipper. I should get back to my duties. Didn't mean to take up so much of your time.
Dismissed, Chief.
Sir.
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taken my resignation pretty hard.
That's tough, but you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Sarah.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right, or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Sarah. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate. Me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it. He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
I suppose I can understand his concern.
You can. But Saren's not going to play by our rules. C-Sec's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
Just because you can break the rules doesn't mean you should. I don't need to stoop to Saren's level to stop him. And neither do you, Garrus.
I see what you mean, but I'll think about it. Thanks, Commander.
Right. Now my favorite character to talk to.
Oh, hello, Shepard.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me. Especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place. The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
I find it rather peaceful. Don't worry, you'll get used to it.
But it's more than just the silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them, but maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually. But we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
I should go.
See you later.
What do we got now? Should probably go back to the Citadel. See if my biggest fan's still there. Actually, might. No, she's not on the Citadel anymore. She'll be at her own private base. Let's do this one. So we want to go to Horsehead Nebula Cluster. In the Strenus system. Okay. We'll find this guy's brother, and then we'll head to the Citadel to turn in that quest, and see if my biggest fan is still there. Or back there again. Joker has anything else to talk about.
Hey, Commander, next time we touch down, let's try not to park the ship in a colony of mutant zombies. Just thinking out loud here.
Nothing new.
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Besides, this is one little comment.
If anyone has to take over for Captain Anderson, I'm glad it's you. I'm not sure about having non-humans on our ship, though.
We're all on the same team here, Presley.
With all due respect, sir, that's what they said about Nihilus. Look how that turned out.
Speak freely, Presley. I want to know if you have a problem with non-humans.
It's not that, Commander. Humanity has always handled its own problems. Saren attacked one of our colonies. We should be the ones to stop it. We don't need their help.
Some people think asking for help is a sign of weakness. That's just being stupid and stubborn. No matter how strong you are, allies can make you stronger.
I guess so. Maybe I'm just stuck in the old ways of thinking. But don't worry, Commander, this won't be a problem.
How did you end up assigned to the Normandy?
I signed up with the Alliance as a navigator right out of school, following in my grandfather's footsteps, I guess. My first posting was on the Agincourt. We were at Elysium during the Skillian Blitz. A massive fleet of alien raiders hit the colony, trying to wipe it out. They had the numbers, but their ships were no match for an Alliance frigate. It was a slaughter. We couldn't even keep track of how many ships they lost.
How'd you end up on the Normandy?
I got my officer's commission after Elysium. Must have made an impression on the right people. Captain asked for me when he was picking his crew.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, sir.
Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
I'll take it in the comm room.
Commander Shepard, we've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
You mean spies?
Spectres tend to attract attention, Commander. But they are only one arm of the Council. Special task groups are often a better option for monitoring developing situations.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Vermeer.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Vermeer. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
Yeah, well, that's going to be put on hold, so... Let's get out of here. We need, let's say, Horsehead Nebula. Said it was here, right? There it is. A faint trail of radioactive particles, possibly exhaust from a sublight nuclear engine drive, leads toward the nearby planet of Zawin. This looks like another... Ah! How it's hitting me. It must have some massive splash damage on the venom of theirs. appears to be no one left at this camp. The generator is still functioning, but there's no sign of the former occupants. The camp's computer notes several locations of interest. Oh, I thought I killed that one. So, one more mineral, one more place of interest after that. Then we can head back to the Normandy. Okay, so that I'm doing. What one was I looking for? Oh, well, can't turn that quest in. Forgot about that. Forgot what I was looking for. Hostile takeover, that's the one. Hunt system of the Gemini cluster and the disk system of Hades Gamma cluster. Okay, so I did that one. So I need to go to the Han system of the Gemini Sigma. Okay. I was just making sure that this base wasn't part of that quest as well.
Everywhere!